Hi there, everyone. Welcome to Temporal Paradox One. My name is Derek from MovieStudioZen.com. In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to create a 1080p or 720p video suitable for upload to YouTube, Vimeo, anywhere on the internet, or for just general playback on your home computer. And I'll be using Vegas Pro 12. So there's an old saying about there's many ways to skin a cat, and that is very true with video editing software and rendering video. So the first thing I like to do these days is not actually do the project properties, but import the main video clips that I'm going to be using. So there's a couple of ways you can import video with Vegas Pro. You can go to File, Import, Media, and then navigate through your computer to find it. You can go to View, Device Explorer, and if you have an ABCHD video camera and it's connected via USB, well, that will show you all the video clips that are on the hard drive or the flash drive of the camera, and you can import it that way. But the third method that I'm going to use today is just, I'm going to go to my Explorer tab, navigate through my own computer, and find the video clip I want to use. And I'm going to choose this one, drag it onto the timeline. Whoops, did that wrong. And this message comes up. Do you want to set your project video properties to match this media? Say yes. Very good idea. Now, I've deliberately chosen this particular clip because it's a little bit unusual. It's 1440 by 1080, not the standard 1920 by 1080. This is just an alternate recording mode on some cameras, and it's designed to sort of keep your file sizes down a little bit. So now we're just going to check the actual project video properties. So you can see there that it's matched everything to this. Better change the resolution to best. Go to audio, change this to best. And final thing before I press apply is, I used to teach people to set up your project properties to match exactly what you want to output your project to. But I've changed my ways because I've found out that when the project properties match the media you are using, it improves the playback quite dramatically sometimes. Whereas if I was to change the project video properties to something completely different to what the video is, then that requires Vegas to do extra work to play it back in real time and make sure it's nice and smooth. So just remember that. Almost forgot something about matching the media settings. If that little window didn't pop up when you imported the video, you can use this icon here, press that, navigate through your computer, find the video clip that you just imported, press open, and that will do the matching process for you. So just remember that. Okay, so now we can do the second part, which is rendering the video, or as Adobe users say, they call it exporting. So we'll go File, Render As, and in Vegas Pro 12, all the internet templates have been moved into main concept AVC/AAC.mp4. So open that up, and if you scroll down, you'll see them there. We've got internet 1080p, internet 720p, and we've got some lower ones as well. So I'm going to just choose that one there. Another quick thing before you go any further is always make sure that if you're about to render a video, that's going to get saved into the right folder. So check up the top there, and if the address looks incorrect, browse and get it fixed up. So we're going to go 1080p, customize template. So I just want to check everything here. And 1080, main, 29, that matches. I like to tick that off. I don't know why that's ticked there for some reason. This is a very important thing. Progressive scan, but because it's an internet template, Sony's already set it up for us. Any video that you make for the internet or for playback on your home computer must be progressive scan, not interlaced. You only use interlaced video on TV sets in some circumstances. If you want maximum quality, just leave the bitrate settings exactly as they are. But if you'd like to shrink the file size down, then you can do experiments and lower this. I know, just as an example, I've basically halved that. I've done videos where I've brought this down to 12 for a maximum and say made the average about 7 or 8. And that still does a pretty good video. Encode mode. Now here is a very important thing, but just before we get to that, I'm going to press system, check GPU. When you go check GPU, it'll tell you which is the correct method to use if you have a dedicated graphics card to use the GPU acceleration feature. Now you may have been hearing me talk about GPU acceleration. There's a setting in the Vegas preferences which controls that feature. Go into options, preferences, video tab. If you have a graphics card that is compatible with Vegas Pro 12, it should be showing in this list and you can select it. If nothing's showing in the list, then it means pretty obvious thing, your graphics card is not compatible. So make sure that is selected. Another thing, if you are experiencing any weirdness when you're rendering, if you've chosen GPU acceleration, well, you may need to turn this off. But don't freak out, because your CPU there is still the main thing that does the bulk of the work in Sony Vegas. So just remember that little tip. I am going to be making a new tutorial very, very soon, explaining all the differences between the NVIDIA cards, the AMD cards, which models work, which models don't, all that sort of stuff. So stay tuned for that. So I'll go back to video, encode mode. So you can use CPU only. NVIDIA users can use the CUDA method, or if you have a AMD Radeon card, use the OpenCL method. But as I always say, do experiments, do alternate methods and see which one gives you the best performance. But I have a decent NVIDIA card, so I'm going to choose CUDA. Go to the audio tab. 192 is pretty cool. That's quite fine for the internet. But if you want to make it a bit juicier, you can always bump that up a bit. And what else is there to say? That's nothing else to say. But just notice, see that when we make a video for the internet, it's now converting it to 1920 by 1080. You don't do the 1440 by 1080 if that's the type of video you imported. It's the end product's all going to be converted to 1920 by 1080. I hope that makes sense. Click OK. Make sure render loop region is not selected, and press render, and Bob's your uncle. And if you were doing a 720p project, you just do the exact same thing. Go through and do what I showed. Now, if you're in the a PAL country, make sure, a very important thing to check is make sure that the frame rate does match your project properties. That's critical to get the best playback performance. So if you shot with a PAL camera at 25, do that. If you shot in 24p mode, then you'll probably use the 23.976. So just remember that, very, very important. And that's it. That's how you render 1080p or 720p video using Vegas Pro 12. Thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and I will see you on the next tutorial. Ciao.